My dear fellow Nigerians, tomorrow being the 16th day of the month of February in the year 2019 is going to be a very critical day in our history as a nation, because we are going to determine if we are going to progress in this democracy that we are into. Tomorrow is going to determine whether or not we are still going to be as one. Tomorrow will determine those who love Nigeria and those who hate Nigeria. So in this 5 minute video, I want to ask us some very critical questions, and I want you to be sincere with yourself. The first one I want to ask you is this: will your conscience be justified after you finish voting? Will your conscience be indeed be justified as to say yes, you are sincere as to whom you voted for? Will it not be that you have already sold yourself for perhaps 5,000 naira or 2,000 naira or maybe a bag of rice? I don't know, maybe you are in such situation right now, but the truth is this: that in our past elections, some persons have come out to say, look, they made mistakes as to who they voted for. But what will be your own remark as you get back home tomorrow? I want you to look at yourself and critically question yourself: am I sincere? Is my conscience going to judge me or not? The second question I want to ask you, dear Nigerians, is how well informed are you? You see, many a times a lot of people make arguments all over the space, social space, for example. You see them walking along the road, even in the bus, that they argue this is the way things are meant to be done. But when you ask them, how is government supposed to be run? How is politics supposed to be done? And they are bereft of ideas. Believe you me, friends, I need you to begin to equip yourself, you know, gather information, question yourself. Look, if you were to be in certain positions today, what would you do? Okay? Start to get informed, because you see these people running around doing campaigning, they know that we are not even well informed. And indeed, when the people are not knowledgeable, they will perish. And that is what we are passing through in this nation, Nigeria. Believe you me, if we don't arise now to equip ourselves with the right knowledge, definitely we will never get to our promised land. The third question I want to ask you is this: whose side are you on? Believe you me, there are certain people today who have decided to say this is who they want to go for. Not many people are in for Nigeria. We should be sincere with ourselves. A lot of people don't wish that we should be one. We should be sincere with ourselves in this country for once. Everyone is just pushing themselves. Let us go, let us go. But indeed, there are many people who are staying about. So whose side are you on? Are you for Nigeria, or are you for those who will continue to eat us dry? Who will continue to take our commonwealth and resources? Who will continue to wreak havoc on innocent citizens? Whose side are you on? Are you going to be among those who will say, oh, the election didn't go in my favor, I'm going to cause this harm to somebody, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that? Whose side are you on? You need to be sincere to yourself this moment. Number four question I want to ask you is, what would you rather do differently if you were the one being voted for? You see, they usually say, give the youth a chance, give the youth a chance. But you see, listen, an average youth today doesn't know his left or right. An average youth today doesn't know what I haven't even found this for a purpose. So tell me, is that the person you want to go and give a presidential post, for example? No. As a matter of fact, if you were asked, how can you run a councillorship post? They don't know. See, that's what we're talking about. So begin to ask yourself, because the person you will vote for is a direct representation of who you are in your heart. So dear Nigerians, I want you to begin to reorientate yourself this moment, that the person I'm going to vote for, listen to me, this is my voter's card. The person I'm going to vote for tomorrow, I know the person, both in the presidential and in the national. Although I have this feeling in my heart that this person may not win, but indeed, I tell you, when I get back home tomorrow, I would have this conscience, this belief that I know whom I voted for. And I believe strongly that Nigeria will get to that level where we'll vote beyond, you know, religiosity, we'll vote beyond ethnicity, we'll vote beyond party affiliation. We'll vote based on conscience, we'll vote based on the same vision that we have for Nigeria. The last question I want to ask is this: do you have a vision for Nigeria? What is the vision you have for Nigeria? You see, we need to go back to restructuring, and that is why for those of you who are watching this video, just below this link here on this YouTube channel, you're going to see a link to a write-up I made some time ago. Nigeria needs to be restructured. There are many regions today who are not feeling the same vibe that we ought to feel. We cannot overlook that. Listen to me, this shirt that I'm putting on now, I got it when we celebrated our 100-year centenary. But if you ask me now, to be fair with you, I don't see us reaching another 100 years. Why? Because there are certain issues on ground that are yet to be settled. And if we want to get to that Nigeria of our dreams, it must be settled. So Thank you very much, and I believe definitely this video has touched your heart. And I want to urge you to please share it out to your friends. If you want to connect to me, you can see my details going down on the screen right about now. God bless you. And just for you to know, my name is Emmanuel Okiyefa. God bless you. I see you getting higher in life, and I see Nigeria indeed becoming that great nation that it ought to be. God bless you.